Evening. We don't have an introduction tonight. It's been locked away someplace in a vault, so we're just going to start the meeting without the introduction. I would ask you all to rise and join us in the Pledge of Allegiance. Chris, if you would, please.
United States Republic, for which is the one nation, God.
Mr. President, please, if you would read the student mission, school mission.
Our mission is to empower all learners to be college and career ready and develop, grow, and achieve as proactive learners.
Dr. Mitchum, agenda.
Yes, Mr. President, I'd like to ask that the board approve the agenda as presented.
Motion?
So moved.
Second.
We have a motion and we have a second. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. The ayes have it. Consent agenda, Dr. Mitchum.
Yes, Mr. Quick. To ask that the board approve consent agenda items 5.1 through 5.4. 5.1, approval of board meeting minutes for February 13th, 2017. 5.2, executive session meeting minutes for February 13th, 2017. 5.3, gifts for Romeo High School, 3 elementary school. 5.4, student activity contract approval request, Jane Adams Middle School with Scholastic Book Fair.
Motion to approve.
So moved.
Second.
Motion and seconded. Any conversation? Hearing none, seeing none. Roll call vote, please.
Member Boudreaux.
Yes.
Member Campbell.
Yes.
Member Zach.
Yes.
Member Perrow.
Yes.
Secretary Sikora.
Yes.
Vice President Felice.
Yes.
President Quigley.
Yes. It's working now. Thank you. Pillars of Valley View. My computer's just coming up. Who is up first?
We have Principal Rollerson from JJL, John J. Lukanczyk.
Rollerson, if you would.
Good evening, President Quigley, members of the board, Dr. Mitchum, senior leadership, and our entire Valley View community. It is an honor to stand before you this evening, being provided the opportunity to recognize a pillar of Valley View, Mr. Ryan Newberry. Mr. Newberry joined us 3 years ago at Lukanczyk as a special education math teacher. It has been a true pleasure watching him grow from his first year of teaching until now. From the moment he walked into JJL, he has been a dedicated staff member who will leave no stone unturned when it comes to supporting students. He brings a variety of strengths to his position, including an official technology guru status, support to students outside of the classroom environment, development of engaging lessons, and a passion for using data to reflect upon his own teaching. The definition of a pillar is a supporting, integral, or upstanding member or part. That he truly is. Not only does he go above and beyond in the classroom, he is involved in supporting many extracurricular activities as well. Most recently, he has taken on the role of co-athletic director here at Lukanczyk. We are truly blessed to have Mr. Newberry as part of our Lukanczyk family. It is an honor to acknowledge him this evening as a pillar of Valley View.
We are back up. Okay. SHA wrestling state finalists. So Rob Rose is coming down.
Members of the community, members of the board, Dr. Mitchum,
senior leadership. My name is Rob Rose. I'm the assistant principal for athletics and activities at Bolingbrook High School. Very honored to recognize several of our students tonight. We will start with our IHSA state wrestling qualifiers. I'm going to bring up Coach Bullivant here in a second. I just want to say a few words about these two gentlemen that we're recognizing here tonight. Dylan Bernowski, who is a sophomore, was a state qualifier last year, placed as a freshman, had an injury later on in the year, and had some trouble at the state tournament, but I have no doubt he's going to make his way back next year as a junior even stronger. He's a great kid as well, one of the best that we have in the building. Another great kid that we have in the building, who I'm so very proud of, is Isaiah Herrera. Isaiah did not start wrestling, correct me if I'm wrong, until your freshman year, right, Isaiah? And worked his tail off to be a state qualifier his senior year. Came up a little bit short with placing, but I cannot say enough about these two kids. They're great for Bolingbrook High School, and they honor us tremendously with their efforts. I look forward to Isaiah doing big things in his career with wrestling at the next level, and like I said, Dylan at the next year as a junior. So I will bring up Coach Bullivant, who will say a few words about each.
Hopefully I don't repeat too much here. I'm definitely honored to be here again, not this time with just one, but two state qualifiers. Dylan, again, two-time state qualifier as just a sophomore. He had a record of 32 wins and just four losses. He battled through significant injury, obviously. One day we're going to get this guy, hopefully by his senior year, to wear a tie to this thing. He gets a get-out-of-jail-free card today with the arm brace. Dylan also made his mark as a sophomore this year, breaking school records again at the Dvorak tournament. He was the Dvorak tournament champion this year, beat a two-time Wisconsin state champ in his finals match to get the job done. Dylan is a product of our highly esteemed Bolingbrook Junior Raiders wrestling program. Definitely has spent the good majority of the 16 years of his life dedicated to this sport. And as Mr. Rose stated, he's definitely going to bounce back next year. Looking forward to seeing him on the podium, Dylan Bernowski. The next state qualifier we had was Isaiah Herrera at 195 pounds. He completed this year with a record of 39-8. Three of his losses were to the 195-pound state champion. Definitely a force to contend with. This young man is driven, ladies and gentlemen. There's not many people that can say without much experience prior to high school that can have this type of level of achievement when they get to the high school level. I'm excited about what both these guys eventually will be doing when they get into their collegiate careers. Very excited. Isaiah in particular, he's kind of an entity of his own. Makes us very proud and is a testament to Bolingbrook High School's wrestling program to be able to get the job done the way he did. Ladies and gentlemen, Isaiah Herrera.
Next, we have a number of students who were state qualifiers with DECA at Bolingbrook High School. Tom Hanlon, our sponsor, teaches a class on Monday night, so that's why he could not be here tonight. So Tammy is stepping in on his behalf. Just want to recognize a few students, and as I call their name, just pause for a little bit. Ms. Conn will hand you their certificate, and then you can start making your way around. Josh Currion placed first in Principles of Business Management and Administration. He's a first-year member in a first-year-only event with approximately 30 students competing. Josh Currion. Asta Gay placed third in Principles of Hospitality and Tourism. First-year member in a first-year-only event with approximately 20 students competing. Asta Gay. Caitlin Spinning, third place in Hotel and Lodging Management Series, third year member, competing with approximately 40 students. Caitlin Spinning. Gabe Ayala, third-year member, BHS DECA president, and Peyton Eakin, second-year member, both top 10 finishers in quick-serve restaurant management out of approximately 25 students. Gabe Ayala and Peyton Eakin. And then I just recognize two students who are not with us tonight. They had previous engagements. Sabrina Amokling, second-year member, top 10 finisher in apparel and accessories marketing services, competing with approximately 45 students. And Jagroop Singh, first-year member, top 10 finisher in principles of marketing, competing with approximately 35 students. Tom Hanlon has done a tremendous job with our DECA students, and I look forward to, I know there's a state competition coming up, and hopefully we can qualify one or more to the national competition. Let's give one more round of applause for our DECA students. Last but certainly not least, we have our JV and varsity competitive dance teams. Just want to give kudos to Coach Kissy and Coach McElroy for the work that they've done with our students. I think this was a year that we really started to solidify the program, and I have no doubt in the years to come they will become more competitive. Both were state qualifiers to the IDTA dance competition in Springfield a couple weeks ago. And our JV competitive dance team actually won the event. So congratulations to our JV competitive dance team.
There you go. You're up.
What's on now? Oh, okay. Thanks for having us here. I want to thank Dr. Mitchum and the board as well. Also want to give a special thank you to Mr. Rob Rose for always supporting the dance team and our principal, Jason Pascavage, as well. Okay. I also want to thank the parents for supporting their students, early 6 a.m. practices, 8 p.m. late night practices, Saturday practices, whenever we needed them to have their students there, they were on board and supported us. So I want to thank the parents as well. I want to thank Coach Kissy and the varsity team for supporting us also. This is the first time in Bolingbrook High School history that a JV Palms team has won a state championship, and I'm very proud of the girls. First, I want to thank Georgia Asamoah. She's our team captain. I want to thank her for her hard work and dedication. She's always been able to receive constructive criticism and feedback, and she always offers ideas for the team. So, Georgia, here you are. Next, I want to thank Denaja Richardson for her choreography, her perseverance. She's been with JV for 2 years, and I know she wanted to be on varsity, but I just want to thank her for enduring, for going through with us, and just being a team player. Thank you so much, Denaja. Yeah. Autumn Armstrong is not here today, but I want to thank her for her creativity, also her perseverance, and her willingness to be on a JV team as well. She had to work tonight. So for Autumn Armstrong. I want to thank CJ Conrad Sylvanus, our only senior and one of the boys, for being willing to be on a JV Palms team. He wasn't ashamed to be on our team, and I want to thank him so much. He brings so many ideas. He's always willing to receive feedback and criticism in order to better his sport. So thank you, CJ. Next, I want to thank Giante Page, our other boy, for being on the team. He won 2 Rising Star Awards with us during the season, and we just want to thank him for his choreography, for his moves, and he was a big part in getting us to state. Thank you, Giante. Next, I want to thank Crystal Johnson. She's one of the kindest, sweetest girls that I've had the privilege to have on the team. She's always willing to receive feedback, always trying to better herself and better the team, and she just brings such a kind, sweet spirit to the team. So thank you so much, Crystal. Next, I want to thank Genesis Adu for being on the team. Genesis came to us with little dance experience, but she worked hard. She was willing to persevere. She received criticism and feedback, and she bettered herself, and she's a great part of the team. Thank you so much, Genesis. Next, I want to thank Brianna Weathers for being on the team. She's always on time. She beats me to practice. She just brings a sweet, kind spirit to the team, and she brings the team together. I also want to thank her parents for feeding the team quite often. We really appreciate that, Mr. Weathers. Brianna Weathers. And lastly, I want to thank Tyra Banks. She's our only freshman on the team. She's also our resident makeup artist. She's our hairdresser. She does whatever we need her to do for the team. So she's a wonderful asset to the team. Her parents are also very supportive, and just so glad to have you on the team, Tyra. And lastly, Diamond Winter. She was a part of our team. She moved to a different school, but I do want to give a shout out to Diamond as well. Thank you.
Good evening, thank you. My name is Brandy Kissy. I'm the varsity dance coach at Bolingbrook High School. I'd like to thank the board, Dr. Mitchum, Mr. Rose, and Dr. Paskavich for recognizing our teams tonight. The girls had a great season and did an exceptional job representing Bolingbrook High School and our community. As a varsity team, we made goals over the summer, and one of those goals was making it to the state competition. Along the way, the varsity team took first place in the hip-hop division at the Dunlap Invitational in December, second place in the hip-hop division, and fourth place in the POM division at the Maine East Invitational in January, where they qualified for the IDTA state competition. They competed at the state competition in February and placed eighth in the hip-hop competition. We have two all-conference members, Alexis Parades and Mackenzie Hulittle. These girls worked extremely hard. They also put in a ton of work, dedication. The amount of hours that they committed was unbelievable. So here are the members of the varsity team. Amber Armstrong. Asia Bear. Nagazi Ade. Mackenzie Hulittle. LaDeja Kimbrough. Alexis Parades. Kylie McFadden. Simone Robinson. And Jordan Sharber. We had three girls that were not able to make it, so I just want to recognize them as well. Asia Hancock, Aaliyah Okubu, and Tiana Barr. Thank you.
Next up, we have the DuPage Township Supervisor Bill Mayer and Trustee Ken Burgess, for those who know him, Smokey, joining us, and they are going to be awarding us a grant, which is always something we like, money.
Good evening, President Quigley, members of the board, Dr. Mitchum, senior leadership, members of the audience and community. The first thing before we speak to this wonderful gift that DuPage Township is going to be giving us, and hopefully we board approve, I just want to wish Dr. Mitchum a happy 35th birthday today. I think 35 is right. Happy birthday. Moving forward, as Dr. Paskavich comes back and joins us over here at the podium, hopefully, it is our pleasure, both Jason and I, to announce that this is a true partnership in seeking out these funds, both Romeoville High School and Bolingbrook High School, working together as one to get as much as we can for our students. That's one thing that I know our teachers see on a regular basis in working with curriculum and different things, but I know athletically and a lot of things in the public, there's always a lot of talk or dispute that the high schools might not be on the same pages, but we are on the same page more now so than ever with Dr. Paskavich coming aboard and working with us and partnering with us and being in the district for a long time. So one of the first things that Jason did when he's accepted the principalship in the fall was inquiring about AP tests and really pushing our advanced learners and making sure that we were giving our kids the opportunities to get college credit while in high school by placing those high scores on our AP tests. So he struck up a conversation with Bill Mayer, invited me to lunch. We sat down and had a wonderful opportunity. So Romeoville High School and Bolingbrook High School together are pleased to announce that DuPage Township is going to be giving us a $2,500 grant this year and a $2,500 grant next year, which equates to about 135 kids or 135 tests purchased for college credit for this year and for next year. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Again, DuPage Township Trustee Ken Burgess is to my left. He is a Romeoville graduate, 1985. Myself, I'm a Bolingbrook graduate, 1989. Both of us came from parents who, if we were in the same situation and took the AP test, would not be able to afford it back then. I remember how much my parents struggled back then, and I was talking to Trustee Burgess, and he said the exact same thing. It's an honor and a privilege to be able to help the parents help their children get college credits. It's been a great honor and a privilege to deal with these two principals. I've known a lot of principals since I've been in Valley View, and these two are fabulous. And that's under the leadership of Dr. Mitchum. So on behalf of DuPage Township, thank you very much.
Since Jim's birthday's been outed, I was thinking if you're born 2 days later, you'd only be 15. Just think of that.
Would I still feel 15?
15. Well, you'll take 50 at this point, won't you? Board liaison reports. Any and all from the right, left, from the left.
Just bear with me because I have several. On the 14th of February, the handbook committee met and discussed revisions that need to be made to the handbook for the district-wide for next year. On the 17th, the district discipline committee met to make sure that the district discipline policies are up to date in the handbook and correlate with the state standards. Brooks Middle School advisory team met on the 21st of February to discuss current programs they have implemented and their up and coming career days they have. Bolingbrook High School on the 21st met the accountability and impact team to continue discussion and results of research of other schools on the wearing of IDs. Thank you.
On the right.
Quick update with regards to Wilco. We will begin informal union negotiation talks the latter part of March. We also are preparing a final list for board approval for Elizabeth Kaufman's replacement, who will be stepping into Katrina Police's role as the executive director. The list has been narrowed down to there's three that will be presented to the board for approval and final interviews. So,
thank you. What else from the right? General Assembly, I give the legislative update. General Assembly, the Senate is in this week. The House was in last week. The House took no budget action. The Senate has said that they intend to vote on what they are calling the grand bargain, which is 13 pieces of legislation all tied together, which as far as I know is a first, that if one does not pass, then none of them pass. There are funding mechanisms for education, funding mechanisms for state agencies. There are tax, what they would call revenues, which are taxes on the people, business taxes, so on and so forth. There's a streamlining of some of those taxes. Whether the Senate will actually take those up this week, it is not known. They have said that they intend to. They said they intended to a couple of weeks ago. That remains to be seen if it will actually happen. An insider in the education portion of government told me that if they don't do something by the end of March towards the budget, the funding drop-offs are going to be substantial, and they're going to be pretty much back where they were a year ago with a part-time budget to just fund education and certain other programs, and we will not have a real working state budget. They can maybe make some things that will help that towards the end of the session in May, which is the 31st, expires the scheduled session. State is currently just in unpaid bills, $12.5 billion, which is almost a third of their operational budget. So that's just backlog of bills. That's what we owe to whomever. Could be schools, could be, you know, the guy who provides, paints the lines on the side of the roads, whatever it is. That's $12.5 billion. The regular operational budget is $35 billion, give or take a few here and there. So they again, you've heard me say it many times, we need to do something about education funding. They need to do something just to pass a budget and get the state of Illinois back and operational again. It's gotten to the point where, you know, this used to be a great state, and when you traveled around other states years ago, people would say, oh, Illinois, yeah, you guys got things figured out. Now we travel and people go, what's wrong with you guys in Illinois? So I hope they can get it together this in the coming weeks and pass a budget. And there's going to be pain in it for everybody. There's nobody that has said otherwise on either side, Republican, Democrat, Independent. If they do pass a budget, there's going to be increase in some kind of taxes, whether it's the sugary drink tax or the income tax or combinations thereof, increasing gas taxes. Who knows? There's a number of these things that have been discussed. What they finally will come up with in a formula at the end is anybody's guess. So that being said, we'll move on to high school liaison reports. Who went first last time? All right, you guys go first this time.
Hello, members of the board and Dr. Mitchum. I'm Nicole Walker. And at Bolingbrook High School, we have been making strides to honor Bolingbrook and honor the community. Our basketball team has been fighting hard through the season and have gone to regionals. And our girls basketball team is also going strong. We have had our tryouts for volleyball and softball already. We held a Black History Month performance that had numbers up to 100. And we have also made steps to help with the preparation for SATs, as well as the preparation for AP tests that are also on the way. We are proud of all of the students that show honor to Bolingbrook and our community. Thank you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen of the board, and a special thank you and a happy birthday to Dr. Mitchum. Bolingbrook has been bustling since our last meeting. Congratulations to our POMS team for making it to state. Our speech season has ended, and we've had numerous school performances, including our choir's pop concert and our speech team performances for lunch and homeroom periods. And I'd like to give a warm thank you to Dr. Paskevich for allowing that to come about. And just 30 minutes ago, me and Nicole came from a Black History Month performance, which went very well. Principal Paskevich has been announcing facts for Black History Month every day, allowing for an inclusive school society. We've also had posters hung around the school giving our students a gentle reminder of our upcoming SATs. Dr. Paskevich continues to encourage every day that Bolingbrook High School strives for a culture of kindness. Thank you.
All Romeoville High School.
Evening, members of the board, village community. Since the start of second semester, RHS has been doing very well and very busy. The main event that we have going on that all parts of the school have been focused is St. Baldrick's. St. Baldrick's is an organization that helps funds for pediatric cancer research. Our students are finding ways to help fundraise for the event that will be held on March 17th in our gymnasium. During that time, families who have been affected or going through the battle of pediatric cancer will be recognized, and students and teachers who have volunteered to cut their hair or at least shave their head for the cause. And in these past weeks, students have accomplished a great deal of fundraising by using creative ideas such as selling baked goods, wristbands, and lollipops, if anything, just to help with the fundraising. Aside from that, our clubs and sports have been doing very well. In the sports sphere, our powerlifting team had placed first at the STAG invite at February 18th. Nine members of that powerlifting team placed first in their all ranking team. The track team hosted a meet on February 24th, and three of our members placed first in their heats. We have Capri Stewart, Xavier Jones, and Nia Lee. Girls soccer and badminton are starting the training of their season and have great potential for, and can't wait to see what the season holds for them. RHS Winter Guard is in their competitive season and are consistently placing the top three in their class. And they have three more competitions until their state championship. Academically, students at RHS have been thriving and continuing to excel and promote the academic values we hold at RHS. Senior Elizabeth Zahorik has been named National Merit Scholar Finalist, and we are waiting to hear about whether or not she will receive a huge scholarship to any company or university that she may attend. Senior Xavier Lampkin was nominated by U.S. Congress Bill Foster to attend the West Point Military Academy due to his leadership and academic qualities. And senior Victoria Zucara just received a $3,000 scholarship from North Central College for her art portfolio and is competing at the SPC ArtCon on March 4th. And lastly, around 20 of our seniors have been named Illinois State Scholars for their achievements in the AP exams last year. And our juniors are continuing to study and prepare for the AP exams and for the SATs that are to be held on April 5th. Thank you.
Before you step down, last year you guys had a GoFundMe page for St. Baldrick's?
Yes, we do. And we still have that. We still have the same thing. And if
you know that you want to, is there a link to it or is that?
Yeah, we have a link to it. We can definitely send it to you guys. So you, if anyone wants to donate, we can send you a link, and that link will automatically give you how much you want to give and a portal to...
You know the guy that was here last year, right?
Tony? He's right there.
There he is, the guy with the hair. He grew back. So you've got a pretty nice little pompadour do there too, bub.
Yeah.
So I'll put $100 down right now if you'll shave your head.
$100.
I was going to say that he really does have a nice head of hair.
You can rub Dr. Mitchum's head for luck and see how it feels.
I'll pony up 102 if he shaves his head.
102.
I'll match it.
That's $200, not 102.
I'll match it.
I'll put 100 in.
There's three.
So you're getting $300 already.
$300. Mm-hmm. I think my beautiful locks deserve just a little bit more. I'm just saying.
Wow.
Okay, I'm in for 100.
Okay, 400. Perfect. Yeah. I will take you upon. Oh, all you're going to see is just straight up shave. Beautiful, bald. All right.
Hopefully, I don't have any scars on that.
Hopefully not. And my associate, Angelica, here, she'll be talking about Black History Month, which is a huge theme that we have at RHS, especially with our main factors being diversity at our school. So thank you so much.
Good evening, members of the board and Dr. Mitchum.
Our clubs have been busy in their activities and got to seek many opportunities in these past weeks. LASSO attended the United Hispanic Leadership Conference on February 16th. It was a great opportunity for our students to learn that attending college is within their reach. The girls from Leadership attended Girls Leadership Conference on February 23rd and had an amazing time with leaders from the area. MSA went to Feed My Starving Children in Aurora February 23rd. They have collected donations from the organization and our packaged food. Best Buddies hosted a ball on February 18th for its members from 5 schools. Everyone had an amazing time. The RHS musical is Footloose, and it is set to start on March 24th and will run until the 26th. The students have been practicing 6 days a week and to create a fantastic show. They all sound great. Black Student Union has held Spirit Month during February for Black History Month, honoring African culture and the achievements of African Americans. They went to Dusable Museum on February 17th to study African history and culture. The club is also hosting a cultural fashion show on February 28th to display all the cultures represented at RHS. Lastly, the students of Amnesty International, which is a new club this year, would like to invite students and staff to attend an important documentary showing on Thursday, March 9th at 2:15 p.m. in the Little Theater. They will be viewing the documentary Poverty Inc. This documentary explores a new perspective of why we still have high rates of poverty in developing nations and the failure of NGOs and government subsidies as solutions. All in all, it has been an exciting start to second semester, and the students have made the school and community proud. We can't wait to see what our school will continue to accomplish in the future, and as always, you can email us about any questions or further information about our events. Thank you, and have a wonderful evening.
Just 1 second. What you said, something was happening tomorrow, the culture, February 28th. I didn't hear the time.
Yes, that is a cultural fashion show. I believe it is starting. Starts at 7. It will be in our main auditorium.
Yes, I'd like to ask the board to approve these items A through C as amended.
So moved.
Second. Motion
and
seconded.
Yes.
Yes. Member Zach?
Yes.
Member Perro?
Yes.
Secretary Sikora?
Yes.
Vice President Felice?
Yes.
President Quigley?
With action report 10.1, we are presenting one board policy for second reading and approval. This was presented previously, and as part of our normal protocol, we routinely review board policy with legal guidance in accordance with the Illinois School Code. We're presenting one policy, 6170, Title I programs, for your approval this evening.
I'll move.
Second.
Motion seconded. Any discussion?
Member Badouris?
Yes.
Member
Yes.
Member
yes.
Zach? Member Perro?
Yes.
Secretary Sikora?
Yes.
Vice President Felice?
Yes.
And President Quigley?
Thank you. Action report 10.2, we are seeking your approval on the high school summer school program for 2017. Information is outlined in this report and was shared previously at the last board meeting. If approved, information will be sent home with progress reports to our high school families. And the first session is scheduled to begin June 5th. So I am happy to answer any questions if you have them.
Hearing none, seeing none. Roll call vote, please.
Yes.
Member Campbell?
Yes.
Yes.
Member Perro?
Yes.
Yes.
Vice President Felice?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, and action report 10.3, we have previously shared information regarding the approval of three new high school advanced placement courses. These three courses are AP Human Geography, AP United States Government and Politics, and AP Psychology. We are extremely pleased to continue to expand opportunities for our students in AP, and our distinction on the AP Honor Roll for consecutive years continues to show that we are expanding opportunities, enrolling students, and in preparing students to earn college credit through the AP exam. So we're pleased to expand the course offerings, and we thank the teachers for their continued efforts in the development of these courses and in preparing our students, most importantly.
Motion?
So moved. Second.
Motion and seconded. Is there any discussion? Hearing none, seeing none. Roll call vote, please.
Member Badouris?
Yes.
Member Campbell?
Yes.
Member Zack?
Yes.
Member Perrill?
Yes.
Secretary Sikora?
Yes.
Vice President Felice?
Yes.
President Quigley?
Yes. Next, Mr. Grisafi.
Yes, while our legislature continues to rack up unpaid bills at an alarming rate, they have managed to pass, and the governor has signed a bill back in July requiring school districts to place certain regulations on the travel, meal, and lodging expenses of its officers, employees, and board members. Basically, the bill prohibits agencies from reimbursing any governing board member, employee, or officer for any entertainment expense, which includes shows, amusements, theaters, circuses, sporting events, or any other place of public or private entertainment or amusement, unless ancillary to the purpose of the program or event. I can assure you that none of these expenses have ever been reimbursed for any board members or employees, but nonetheless, the legislature is requiring us to pass this resolution. It will regulate reimbursement for all travel, meal, and lodging as discussed. If after 180 days, the effective date of the act, or June 30th, such resolution has not been adopted, no travel, meal, or lodging expenses may be approved or paid by the local public agency. The resolution must regulate at a minimum the types of official business for which the travel, meal, and lodging are allowed, the maximum allowable reimbursement for those expenses, and also must provide a standardized form for submission of travel, meal, and lodging. Again, all of this has been in place in the school district for a long, long time, but again, it's just more formalized at this point. And so at this time, we are recommending the board approve policies 2125 and 560 to maintain compliance with the Travel Expense Control Act.
So moved. Second.
We have a motion, we have a second. Any discussion?
Yes, I'd like to make a motion to change the subject or change the amount from 2,500 to 2,000 as referred to by Mr. Grisafi and the amount spent by each board member yearly.
I'll amend the original motion.
Original was 2,500. I'd like to amend it to 2,000.
So we need a second on that motion.
Second.
So we have a motion. We have a second on that motion. So that amends the original motion. Help me out here, parliamentarians. Yes. So what are we voting on?
2,000.
All right. So
voting on the 2,000 instead of the 2,500.
We were at 2,000, correct, Gary?
Yes, we were at 2,000, correct. I believe it was a typographical error in in the policy that went out.
Okay.
Changed to 2,500. So all right. 2,000 is where we currently are.
So we have a motion and we have a second on the amended motion. Is there any discussion or further discussion? Hearing none, seeing none, I suppose we're at a roll call vote.
Member Badouris?
Yes.
Member Campbell?
Yes.
Member Zack?
Yes.
Member Perrill?
Yes.
Secretary Sikora?
Yes.
Vice President Felice?
Yes.
President Quigley?
Yes. All right. Next up, Ms. Hawks.
Thank you, President Quigley. Action report 12.1 this evening is the consolidated action report for certified and classified personnel. We're seeking your approval on 13 items for certified personnel, 43 items for classified personnel, and 2 items for classified administrative personnel.
So moved.
Second.
Motion and seconded. Any discussion? Hearing none, seeing none. Roll call vote, please.
Member Badouris?
Yes.
Member Campbell?
Yes.
Member Zack?
Yes.
Member Perrill?
Yes.
Secretary Sikora?
Yes.
Vice President Felice?
Yes.
President Quigley?
Yes. Next, Dr. Mitchum. Superintendent Information Report. You got anything?
No.
How profound. Legal Services report.
No formal report.
Thank you. Associations, AFT.
Excuse me, did we do Consolidated Action Report 12.1?
Yep. Yes. We just did that.
Sorry.
You're thinking about that birthday cake, aren't you?
Getting old.
Valley View Council report. Valley View Office Personnel Council report. Any business, old business before the board? Any new business before the board? Any questions from the public on actions we have taken this evening? Seeing none, we'll move down to the next announcements by the board. Ms. Sikora seems to have something she would like to announce.
It's not my night to talk. Come on. Just a reminder that the Valley View Enrichment Foundation dinner is on March 10th. All proceeds are used to fund grants for teachers, and the price changes after tomorrow. So it goes up by $10, I believe, as of March 1st. Correct, Ms.? Thank you, Mrs. DeLamonte.
And the theme is still Margaritaville. Thank you.
couple brief announcements. I'd like to remind and invite everybody this coming Sunday on March 5th at 1 p.m. Heart Haven Outreach is hosting their annual 3-on-3 basketball tournament at Brooks Middle School. Thank you to Dr. Wood and Dr. Mitchum for having that space available for Heart Haven Outreach. If you watch some of the current varsity basketball players, not so many years ago, they were playing in this Heart Haven Outreach 3-on-3 tournament. So it's a good thing. Come out and support. Tip off is at 1, and it's $1 to get in. I don't think there's a better deal in town on a Sunday afternoon. I would like to thank both principals, Mr. Kinder, Mr. Paskavich. It is truly very much a pleasure to see something I haven't seen in the many years that I've lived in town, how both high schools are working well together and communicating and offering best practices and so forth. You guys should be commended because it goes all the way down to the students through the teachers and the staff. So thank you to that. And finally, a quick shout out to the building services who has organized the move. I know it's not done, but I'm hearing there's very little boxes lost, and that's good, and that's quite an accomplishment. So thank you for that, because ultimately it's no disruption to the students and to the staffs and the teachers, with that being the main hub. So congratulations to everyone that's been a part of that, from just moving stuff to organizing it. So congratulations.
Anyone else? I've got one, or actually a couple things, but the St. Patrick's, the Bolingbrook Lions, St. Patrick's corned beef and cabbage, Saturday, March 11th, 7 o'clock till midnight at the Levy Center, $30 per person, says casual attire. Cash bar, Maurice the entertainer will be the entertainment. I'm sure there'll be Irish dancing, so on and so forth. The Lions are the ones who have supported the Lions Foundation has supported screening of all of our kindergarten students for vision. So they're to the tune of about $5,500 a year that they have contributed the last couple of years to vision screen our kids and give them a leg up. And I would encourage everyone to come out and support that. And also did want to acknowledge Jim's birthday. Congratulations on living this long.
And for the record, he's not 35 either.
And also I want to thank Bill Mayer and the township for their contributions to helping students who may not be able to afford taking an AP class. Derek and Jason, you guys should be commended for getting together on this. I have a son, I'm sure I paid for his class, but I have a son who took 3 AP classes and passed them all. And the value of that, when you start your son who's looking at his freshman year next year, that's 3 classes I don't have to pay for.
Likewise.
And that's a big lead up for a lot of kids. And now that we're opening this up to 5 or 6 or, well, 3 different classes and so on and so forth, that's going to make a huge difference for some parents. And if you do this right, you could start your freshman year a whole semester ahead, maybe even more, depending on what classes you take and how those are accepted. But a 3-point or a 3-grade gets you just about every school. A 4-grade gets you every school, and a 5-grade gets you into some of the best schools in the country. It's just that simple. So hopefully students will take more and more advantage of this as we offer more and more programs, and it just goes to show the excellence of what we're doing here in Valley View, and I think you guys should be commended for your efforts, and I want to thank the supervisor of township and his folks for getting behind that effort as well. So thank you. Beyond that, any announcements by the board or the administration?
Yes, I have one. I just wanted to remind the public that we've begun our move to the new administration center, and that we will complete that move on Friday of this week. And the new address is 801 West Normantown Road in Romeoville, Illinois. Also, I'd like to thank Mike Lopez for all his due diligence. We've had some snags along the way. We were concerned about being able to open the place in time to have the early childhood center open at the beginning of the 17-18 school year, but as a result of his hard work and pressure and cajoling and massaging, we were able to do that. And so we will be fully out of there at the conclusion of this week, but we've begun that process today. So I believe the educational services is over there, and Gary, your team is over there as well. Sharon Hawks will be moving Wednesday, and I can't, what else, who else is moving?
Enrollment will be the last department Friday.
Okay, enrollment on Friday. That's it.
Any announcements by the public? Motion to adjourn would be in order.
Oh.
Motion seconded. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, same sign. The ayes have it. Have a safe evening. Happy Mardi Gras. Happy Lent. Happy Fat Tuesday. Ash Wednesday.